There's a lot of talk about how does the moon impact deer movement. And fortunately, through the use of GPS radio collars, we have lots of years of data now on deer herds across the whitetails range. And we can look at movement patterns in relation to all kinds of environmental factors. Temperatures, rain, snow, moon phase, wind, all these different variables. And as hunters, we're always looking to key into something that can help us, you know, put us in closer position to shooting a deer during the fall. And we grab onto things like moon phase, because oftentimes, you know, my dad or my grandpa or a hunting buddy told me that following the full moon, deer feed all night, so they rest all the next day. So days after full moon tend to be poor days to hunt. Well, we take a look at what the research shows on this. In fact, we find this is a big myth, that regardless of moon phase, there's not a big difference in actual deer movement patterns during the night of those and then the following day. There are a little subtle differences during some of the different phases of the moon, but not the big overriding factor like many hunters believe. So when it comes time to when should I hunt, or should I plan a vacation around the full moon or not, and I know many people, and I know some very good hunters who really believe in that. But it's kind of like if it's your favorite fishing lure, you know, when you're fishing it, you fish it a little bit harder because you believe in it a little more. I think that's some of what the hunting after a full moon or not hunting after a full moon is, because people believe in that or not. But suffice to say, the research is very, very clear on that, that deer are not necessarily feeding a lot longer during the night in a full moon and resting more the next day. So if it's an opportunity to go hunting and it just happens to be the day after a full moon, absolutely go hunting. Don't let that old myth keep you in the woods and miss out on the deer of a lifetime. So now that we've dispelled the myth that the moon dictates a bunch of deer movement during the night from a feeding activity or maybe resting more the next day, what are some of the things that really drive deer movement? Well, one of the things is time of year. You know, deer are built to feed and then escape from predators for almost the entire year. The time that changes is obviously during the breeding season, where they want to feed and breed. So those are the two driving factors. So all other things being equal, deer want to feed during the daylight. They're crepuscular, which means they're most active at dawn and dusk. Those are the main feeding periods. And in areas where they are not heavily pressured, they tend to feed a little longer during both of those. One of the best ways that we can actually change deer movement is to pressure deer or let them know that folks are in the area to make them then want to shift those feeding patterns to during the night. So hunters say, you know, like, what do I need to know about deer movement? One is that, hey, this is when they want to be out there, dawn and dusk the most. Let's not interfere with that so that we can use that to our advantage to be able to see them during shooting hours. So our activities, as much as anything, can have a big impact on actual deer movement patterns. A second thing that really plays into some of these feeding patterns are some of the environmental variables that we see. Some rain events, some wind events, and it's been extremely difficult to kind of tease out some of those, like barometric pressure. And a lot of people say, ooh, as that barometer is falling, that means a storm is coming and that we are going to have good hunting. And in fact, there's no research has been able to actually clarify that or confirm it. Now, I have seen this enough to fully believe myself as a hunter, and you know, maybe not the biologist in me, to think that there is something there. And I think it's probably a combination of variables that we just haven't teased out enough yet, because there's no study that shows that the barometer changing is having big impacts on deer movement. But one thing that we have seen from current research projects based out of Penn State University is the impact that rain has on movement patterns for bucks and does. And a lot of hunters on a real rainy day will stay home thinking deer are going to be bedded and wait out the storm. And in fact, that is absolutely the opposite of what's actually happening. What they find is as they follow these deer throughout the course of the year, during rain events, now I'm not talking monsoons or really heavy rain, but just natural rain events actually cause deer movement to increase during daylight hours. So the old myth that when it's raining, deer are bedded, stay home, is absolutely false. If you have the opportunity to hunt a rainy day, particularly during the early fall of the year, those can be the absolute best days to be afield. So should you pee in the woods when you're deer hunting? I know hunters who are on total opposite ends of the spectrum saying, you know, they would never pee in the woods. You know, they carry bottles with them, they carry bags with them. And I know others who pee in the woods on a very regular basis. And then I will say this, there is some research to justify, maybe if you're peeing in the woods, it's not necessarily a bad thing. Years ago at Penn State University, they did a study of rutting bucks, and where they took doe and heat urine, they took doe out of heat urine, just normal deer urine, they took human urine, and they took new car smell, and they put them into these different scrapes, monitored them to see which ones actually attracted bucks during the rut. And what they found was that the human urine attracted just as many bucks as the doe and heat urine did to these scrapes. So we get so tied into this, oh, it's a rutting thing that the deer have, and they only cue in on that, But in reality, that scrape is a place for deer to communicate. So regardless of what type of smell is in it, they see that disturbance in the ground, that's a visual thing. There is a smell there, so they want to come and check it out. They then often will leave their own scent there to be able to communicate with others. But it was very clear that even with that human urine in it, attracting just as many bucks as that doe and heat. So while you're deer hunting, you know, is it really hurting you to pee in the woods? Not at all. And in the case of actually peeing in the scrape, you may actually be attracting some deer to the area that you're in.